That's weird, right? Yeah. You don't put this like on an ordinary coat,
no.
Like Jimmy Cornette's hand-me-downs.
Yeah, from Salvation Army or anything,
this
you know.
This goes on like this?
This goes on backwards, you start it out.
And this will incapacitate someone, yes. David. There's no doubt. Look at it.
Okay. And now you got three straps to go across the back.
Three straps on the back,
Tony.
Exactly. And this is so tight. Once you put it on somebody, I know they're very, you know, not going to be able to move because it's so tight on my shoulders and stuff right now that it's getting tight. It'll cut your wind away.
I'll just put on a couple of them just to show the people.
Okay. Yeah, midnight.
Putting Cornette in the straitjacket.
Okay, what do you do with the arms now?
Yeah, what about the arms?
Okay, the arms cross in front of you here. Yeah,
this way, right?
Yeah, this way, right around here. And the step comes around here.
Oh, my goodness.
Then what are you going to do?
Well, there you see Bobby Fulton.
Jimmy Cornette, yes.
It's pretty tight up in the straitjacket.
Can you imagine, David, Jimmy Cornette in this thing? And this goes back across here.
Goodness.
Across the back here. And latches it in.
Hold it. Yeah, that's awful tight, man. I can't even move at all, man.
There's nothing he can do.
There's nothing.
Absolutely nothing. There is absolutely nothing that he can do.
I want to see where he puts the tennis racket.
The straps come down around the legs, too, so he makes sure he ain't going to get away for sure.
That's a good one.
You know, Gary Hart, what Jim Cornette did, you'd probably do, wouldn't you?
I think it was terrific. I think that Jimmy Cornette picked the right time and the right spot, the way that I plan to pick the right time and the right spot, and it's getting very close. Week after week, I've heard Nikita Koloff come out here and talk about Al Perez and Gary Hart. Well, you see, where I come from in Chicago, you don't talk about doing something. You do the deed, then you talk about it. The Great American Bash is coming. And what is going to take place to Nikita, we are going to make such an impression upon you in a very short time that you will never have the guts to come out on TV and ever say anything about Al Perez or Gary Hart again. Because you remember something, Russian. This is not your country. We did not adopt you. We do not want you. And I've said this before, but I think it has to be very, very clear. I want to use an analogy. The other night I was in an arena and I heard the people hollering at Barry Windham that Barry Windham was a traitor. Well, let's think who really are the traitors. When the American public is so brainwashed that they cheer for a stinking, lousy, low-life Russian like yourself, Nikita, that is a traitor. And anybody that will raise their voice and scream for Nikita, you are nothing more than a hypocrite. And I don't think that you should ever say anything about Barry Windham, a fine young American. If you really want the truth of the matter, it is this. Dusty Rhodes, you know that you turned against Barry Windham. You also know you are the one that brought Nikita, got him to defect. So remember something. Very soon, in the very near future, David, Nikita may not be here. It's a good possibility because, as I said, from where I come from on Halstead Street in Chicago, we do it right. And when we do it, I think I've said enough.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's go to the ring and watch his men in action.
His men are Al Perez, Larry Zbyszko against Gary Phelps and Dale Laperouse in this event. Well, what we had seen, and I want to see this, say this right at the top of it, right before the break, was certainly unexpected. And I apologize for even asking about seeing the straitjacket being put on, Jim Ross, because the Midnight Express were not scheduled to be here. They said they would not be here. We didn't see them, and they came out of nowhere. And Cornette really looked brave when he had Bobby Fulton tied up in the straitjacket.
He came out here last week and whined around that he wasn't going to come back until basically he got his way. And it's pretty once again that Jim Cornette has a very hard time telling the truth.
And what it does is just, as the cliche goes, adds fuel to the fire to that situation.
Well, what he is doing is he's putting himself into an athlete's position by getting physical with the Fantastics. If you put yourself into position of being of an athlete, you're going to be treated like an athlete if you want to function in that environment. And that's what Jimmy Cornette is doing right here. That's something he has to be very careful of. I don't think he even lettered in checkers in high school.
Tag is made. The great athlete Al Perez, the Western State champion Larry Zbyszko, working on Gary Phelps. And we heard from Gary Hart some very strong comments about Nikita Koloff and about the fans. And he is cheered all around the country.
Zbyszko verbally abusing referee Teddy Long here on World Championship Wrestling here on the Superstation.
As you take a look at Gary Hart, back to that situation with Cornette, the chair was a part of it. They leveled him on the head with the chair. I do hope both of them are all right. I know they were helped off during the break. We haven't heard of their situation. Certainly a helpless situation for Bobby Fulton at that time.
Great suplex by Al Perez. This is what a wrestling machine he is. You know, we've talked about the wrestling machines like Mike Rotunda and Dr. Death Steve Williams. We talked about, of course, Nikita Koloff earlier in the hour. This man here is, as you can tell by looking at him, ladies and gentlemen, he is just in phenomenal condition.
Oh. He is one of the heavy hitters in our sport, such as a Ronnie Garvin. He has such a very strong right hand and a forearm that we saw right there coming off the ropes. But he loves that spinning toe hold. That's his move, even though that right hand and the right arm is very effective. And what a move that is.
Laparouse, the rangy one from the Bayous, looked like a mad stork, whirling around like a frisbee there. Double teaming tactics by Perez and Zbyszko. Certainly this is a great team, but more importantly, the situation that Gary Hart perhaps making a comment that they're picking their time and their place for Nikita Koloff. Very interesting comments by Gary Hart, who I think he thought he may have said too much and really clammed up in a hurry.
Well, I know that Hart is the type of manager that does have a lot to say about his man's career, about what he does and what direction he takes.
Al Perez, a great star wherever the NWA might go, and speaking of the National Wrestling Alliance, will be in St. Martin and St. Thomas in the next few days.
Ring the bell, ring the bell.
Referee calling for the bell right there. Spinning toe hold. This one is over.
Stomping away, Zbyszko will not let up, neither will Perez. What a combination.
Hey, a little competition would be nice. Get these guys out.
The year, and they go back and look at some of those exciting wrestlers in the world.
Pay attention to what's going on in here, okay?
One of the most exciting wrestlers in the world. Sting would have to be at the top of everybody's list.
I was on a plane the other day with former Oakland Raider Pete Banaszak, and he said he got hit so hard one time he had stingers running down his arms, both arms, stingers that had run all the way out my fingers. And it reminded me, I said, well, we got a wrestler called the Sting. He said, you bet, I know all about the stinger. Pete Banaszak, two times.